Hi, I'm Patrick from Microsoft. As a company-wide initiative and mandatory security policy since 2004, the Security Development Lifecycle, or SDL, has played a critical role in embedding security and privacy in software and culture at Microsoft. Combining a holistic and practical approach, the SDL aims to reduce the number and severity of vulnerabilities in Microsoft Online services. It does this by embedding comprehensive security requirements, technology-specific tooling, and mandatory processes into the development and release lifecycle. It is developed by security subject matter experts and in accordance with industry best practices and regulatory standards for compliance. All Microsoft Online services must follow Microsoft's secure development and operational security requirements. While SDL tools run automatically as part of the build to detect security issues within the code, operational security requirements help maintain security best practices. In addition, engineers participate in a wide variety of training to help build security awareness and knowledge. This video will walk you through the core principles of the security development lifecycle and operational security processes at Microsoft. To ensure that Microsoft engineers cultivate a defensive mindset and have an awareness of emerging threats, all employees are required to take basic security awareness training, both as part of their initial onboarding, as well as annually in order to maintain access to production systems. In addition, all members of software development teams have access to advanced security and privacy training. This includes personnel who are full-time employees, interns, contingent staff, subcontractors, and even third parties. As the implementation of new features are planned, threat models are created or updated to represent the new data flows between components specific to these functional scenarios. The associated data flow diagrams allow for a study of an application's security and privacy risks by outlining primary functional flows and capturing details such as data flows between components, sequence of interactions and protocols used, and sensitive data handling and storage. Microsoft integrates mandatory security tooling at different phases of the engineering process. These phases are generalized as development, check-in, build, and post-release operations. So, what are these different types of tooling? First, static code analysis tooling is used to analyze source code and identify patterns that could have a potential security impact. Next, there's binary analysis tooling. It is used to assess threats and vulnerabilities at the binary code level and confirm that each build is production ready. Credential and secret scanners are used to identify possible instances of credentials and secret disclosures in source code and configuration files. Encryption scanning tooling is used to validate encryption best practices, both in code and operation. Endpoint scanners are used to scan endpoints for known vulnerabilities and misconfigurations. There's also fuzz testing tooling, which uses malformed and unexpected data to exercise APIs and parsers, looking for vulnerabilities and failures, as well as validating proper error handling. And finally, configuration validation tooling analyzes the configuration of production systems against security standards and best practices. Penetration testing of Microsoft Online services occurs periodically and is conducted by both internal teams and external providers. We also have a bug bounty program that invites researchers to submit possible security findings that they have discovered. The use of open source software is strongly encouraged at Microsoft. Building on the efforts of others allows us to create a meaningful value for our customers faster and engage with new ecosystems and user bases in a natural way. However, Microsoft also understands that there are unique risks and responsibilities associated with using open source. The Microsoft Open Source Programs Office, in cross-company collaboration with legal, security, and business stakeholders, have put together a comprehensive suite of policies, processes, and tools to help our developers work with open source in a secure fashion. On at least a yearly cadence, through third-party audits, Microsoft Online services demonstrate that these security requirements are being met. Microsoft is continuously investing in its people, security awareness programs, and best-of-breed tooling to focus on measuring and alerting of known risks. Thank you for watching. Additional papers and external audit reports can be found on the Service Trust portal.